Dinosaur kid is safe now. Is he? Selfish and insolent. Just
wake
you
up.
Need to know
Come on,
things.
Wake up.
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on. You've got to wake up. You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be complete. I don't set the world on fire.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. James. Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a dead man.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations and there will be...
Don't look straight into
James
the light
and
now.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations, may your future be bright. Boys in this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course, I miss it.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too
it
fast.
Stays more than last.
You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh, man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish...
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not, imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on us.
Yeah, Paul.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Who do you mean, Dorkface here? Happy birthday, Dorkface.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amada put into this party. She really seems to like you. For some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the Overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Bum, it's time to cut the cake.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Andy, wait! Hey, happy birthday,
man. Oh,
no.
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer. How about we share it? What are you, five? Give me that sweet roll, I'm gonna pound you. Yeah, right. Thanks, loser. Oh, and happy birthday!
Nonsense.
Come on,
people
Wally.
Always you enjoy my little speeches. Besides,
yeah,
that friend of yours
got
can use a reminder
the
that life is not all
super
fun.
Happy
cool,
birthday!
Right?
Jeez, Wally.
What happened with Butch? He looked awfully pleased with himself, which usually means something bad happened to somebody. I know. Butch. What else is there to say, right? Hey, forget him. Have fun. It's your birthday party.
Another
who's the head
youth
of the gang?
Well
you're
on
me.
His way
no
to
way.
Becoming a another youth well
Do you think
on his way
him?
To becoming a productive
I'm sure
citizen.
Of it, Amata.
Thanks for coming,
Snakes
Stanley.
Are cool, right?
I know you were
Both
busy
snakes.
With the water purifier. Everything's
you
fine,
and your snakes
I
and rats and wizards.
Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me
no.
and Andy got her all
I
fixed up again
I've
last night. Good as new.
I wasn't worried.
What do you think we should call our gang?
You can fix anything,
it's gotta be
right?
Totally killer.
Anyway, I'm
hey,
glad
how
you
about
can
those
make
vault
it.
Dwellers? Get it?
How's it going, pal?
Who wants to go around all day being called
enjoying
a
yourself?
Hey there, pal. Having fun?
I think you really
how
are as dumb as you
party,
look.
Mrs.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Who wants to go around
I
all day being called a
you know?
Sometimes I think you really are
oh,
as dumb
really?
As you look.
They're lovely.
You Listen, once you have finished being a good job. Host, I have something I want to show you.
Hello, Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part
enjoying
of my job.
Yourself?
Plus, well, I like
enjoying
parties.
Yourself?
Jonas?
Sure thing,
hey,
Officer
Paul.
Gomez.
Hobbies
well, it's been
Whoa.
Nice chatting with
That's
you.
Your
Thanks.
Hobby?
Thanks again
I'll
for
send
coming.
Him right down.
Now quit.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Give me an idea for what to name our gang.
Isn't being a gang a little stupid? I mean, basically everyone we know is going to be in it.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
I'll tell you one person who's not going to be in it. You! Just kidding, Paul. No, I wasn't. Yes, I was. Psych! Show us how smart you are, Wally. What should we call ourselves?
If you're so smart...
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself. Your dad is waiting to give you your present. Or should we just keep it?
Are you ready for your surprise? The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter, Gloria. So what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. Beginning and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. I got out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right?
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone? Stupid tunnel snakes! Immature assholes, if you ask me! Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please? Thanks. You've always been a good friend. Try talking to Butch. They'll all do whatever he says.
She's nothing, Butch. I look like I want a chit-chat nosebleed. What, you want another beating? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me? And who are you? Her boyfriend? Ha! Keep talking like that, boy, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix.
Did you know
Vault-Tec water.
Like I'm gonna listen to a little shrimp like you. Get lost, Poindexter. Her weight, huh? I can see why. You're okay, Pipsqueak. Now run along before you get hurt.
Go away, you stupid tunnel snakes!
You're all right, kid. You put on a couple of pounds of...
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will. Especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good. Let me know if there are any changes.
Hi, Stanley.
Buzz off, nosebleed.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Remember, Vault 101 is America.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation. And a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. you decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants. They say the goat never lies. According to this, you're slated to be the next vault chaplain. God help us all. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Hello. I hope you weren't just talking to me.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see.
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
Anything is possible, even an A.
That is Dr. Brotch. Here to save you now. Is selfish and insolent is just
wake
you
up.
Need to know.
Come on, wake up.
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on. You've got to wake up. You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there!
Crime, any more roaches? Had enough?
Get it off me!
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rad roaches. Oh my God! Thank you! I didn't know what to do! You're the best!
Ow, that hurts! Butchie, help me! Ah! Stop it! What's happening?
We did it! My mom's gonna be okay! You're the best friend I've ever had, man! Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
That is all.
Here. You like that, you bastard? Had enough?
Where do they keep coming from?
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Be careful! Tom! No!
Oh! Any remnant found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely.
Oh!
Bring it!
Oh!
you eventually. Oh!
God, I almost didn't believe it was possible. No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you. It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Thank you.
are the surest criterion by which to determine...
Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too when the need arises. Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like. I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with? Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. Sure thing, partner. What do you need to find? Our clinic is down in the crater, by the bomb. Doc Church is a little rough around the edges, but the man's got talent and compassion. Sure is. Moriarty's. The entrance is on the top level, opposite the main gate. Just be careful. Moriarty is not your friend, no matter what he may say. So don't fall for his lies. And for God's sake, don't trust the man. You'll probably want to see Moira at Craterside Supply. She sells some weapons. Makes some too, from what I hear. Her place is down by the crater. Moira sells all kinds of stuff at her place. Craterside Supply. Take a guess where it is. Up at Moriarty's at the south end of town. Talk to Nova. She'll help you out. Sure thing. What's on your mind? Carry on.